municipal elections to 120 municipalities and 9 municipal corporations happened on the 22nd, and the results are out today. And I have with me Mr. KT Rama Rao. Many congratulations. A century once again here. You were talking about a century during the assembly and did extremely well. The role seems to be going on. What is the significance of winning so many seats at a time when the opposition really was hoping to give you a run for your money?
Well, not just this municipal election, but I think ever since the state has been formed, since 2014 until now, we won every single election, be it rural election or urban election, or be it even the assembly elections or the parliament elections. We won every single election. That goes to show you that when a leader is committed with a clear vision and a clear agenda of development and welfare, and the execution is also spotless, then I think the people will only continue to support. Today, what has been achieved is incredible, because out of the 130 municipalities and corporations that have gone out for voting on 22nd, 100 plus have been won by TRS, which is more than 80%. So therefore, you know, I think it's incredible. We are I want to extend, express my deep sense of gratitude to the people who have voted for us, and to the, you know, lakhs of people that have worked hard for us, the TRS workers and the leaders who've struggled really hard, who've worked really hard, and more importantly, for the people who continue to repose faith in the leadership of our Chief Minister, Sri K Chandrashekar Rao.
During the parliament elections, your vote percentage did go down and the numbers did come down from what you were expecting, certainly. Do you see that as an aberration? What happened?
I think it is an aberration. If you look at it, there are two things that we have to, analyze and understand. Firstly, the number of parliament seats won by the TRS in the Lok Sabha elections is still, in fact, more than all of our opposition combined, if you do the math. And then secondly, you have to remember, while we continue and while we want to win every single election that there is, sometimes these aberrations do happen. And once again, today it has been proved very, very clearly, beyond any doubt, be it a rural election or an urban election, the vote electorate is with KCR Garu and TRS party. So, like I said, that definitely was an aberration.
The question came also because a party like the BJP, from one lone assembly seat, they went to, the numbers grew up so much when they came to parliament. So, what happened? Are the factors different there and here? And why is the BJP and the Congress, in a sense, not able to get its act together?
Well, I think that's a question that they have to ask for themselves, not me. I don't think you have to ask their spokespersons as to why they've won some seats. I think if you ask me, it was fluke. So therefore, whatever they won in parliament was a mere fluke, and that is being reinforced today, especially after the rural elections and the urban elections. Because if their victory was credible in Lok Sabha, whatever they won, they should have also continued to maintain the same momentum in other elections that followed.
AIMIM, your friendly party, but one of your ministers calls it an old city party. Is your view the same on it?
Well, these things happen during elections. In the heat of elections, a lot of things get said and unsaid later. So, therefore, I'm not too worried about it.
On the CAB, your party, of course, voted against. But why is it that the Chief Minister has not really spoken publicly, despite an MIM and others appealing to you to, say, speak out on NPR, on NRC?
I think the Chief Minister is holding a press meet today. I think you should ask him this question. Because, see, when, as a party, when we had to take a stand, I think on the right forum, in both houses of the parliament, Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha, we spoken. You think Mr. Nama Nageshwar Rao and Mr. Keshwar Rao would speak out of turn without the party's permission, without the leader's permission? They obviously were given the party line, and they told the party line they voted against the CAB.
So therefore, political reasons leading up to the municipal elections that made you silent?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. See, I don't think local elections are fought on issues such as this. BJP might want, people to actually fight, make this the main plank as part of an election. But I don't think people have looked at it that way. They've tried very hard. In fact, BJP's central leadership has come down and campaigned in municipal elections, whereas we, on the other hand, we have left it to our local leadership and our chief minister, our party leaders. We have not campaigned.
In the run-up to this, everyone speculating Mr. KT Rama Rao will now take centre seat and Mr. KCR will probably remain the visionary there.
Well, I think I have a very good seat right now, and I think I'm happy with it. And as I've said it in the run-up to the municipal elections, my job is cut out. Today, the people faith, people posing so much faith in, the TRS government again, gives me an opportunity to execute my new municipal act very, very strongly. And the fact that people have endorsed, a TRS very strongly, and I have the fact that I have 4 years in government to make sure that the implementation happens on the ground, I think that my task is cut out, and focus on that.
Just taking one step back, you've just returned from Davos. And what's the pitch you made there? And we saw you everywhere visible. What's the outcome from that?
Well, Davos is not just about bilateral meetings and attracting investments. It is also about understanding what is going on in the world, what is the world talking about. See, I wouldn't have, you know, learned so many things. For example, there was an amazing discussion with Sundar Pichai on quantum computing and the breakthrough that Google has had recently. I'm looking forward to seeing what outcomes it would actually offer an emerging nation like us, an emerging state like us. Secondly, there was discussion on synthetic biology. There was discussion on climate change. So it's not just about bilateral meetings and attracting investments, while that is the main focus, of course. I've had more than 50 bilateral meetings. I've had more than 5 to 6 panels where I've participated. I had the ability, had the good opportunity to interact with a number of world leaders, and just broadens your perspective, gives you a wider sort of a canvas for you to showcase your state. And the fact that today people have come to recognize Telangana as a force to reckon with in terms of attracting investments within India, I think therein lies the whole point of going there.
Thank you so much, and congratulations once
again.
So, the TRS certainly on a roll with successive elections that they have won with very, very convincing majorities. In Hyderabad, with camera person Nagraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.